Ananda Chudasama of Kalahuda Art Festival requested me to do a video about my art practice, a day in my studio. Now, it's very difficult for me to talk about a day in my studio because I don't have one studio, I have many studios. I work in my studio, which is there on the top of the museum. There's a large room where I do my thinking and drawing. And I have a studio on the beach because almost 50-60% of my work actually happens on the beach. So the beach itself becomes my studio. I work in the fields, so the fields are also my studio. So I have multiple studios. During COVID, I must admit that I spent a lot of time in my studio in Museum of Goa. For 3 months, when the museum was closed, I was just in my studio all by myself. And I must tell you that during COVID, I created more work than I have ever created. I had almost uninterrupted creative time. And I'm actually very grateful that I had this opportunity. I used to do very few drawings, but the COVID actually brought out the drawing talent of mine. So I must have done thousands of drawings within this 1 year. I have been also drawing on pieces of wood which I collect during my walks on the beach. I go to the beach, collect the pieces of wood which are basically pieces of old boats which are in the ocean, when the ocean brings them to the shore, especially during monsoon. And I pick them up, treat them and make a drawing on these pieces of wood. So when I do that, the whole history of this piece, a lot of textures are created on this piece of wood by the ocean itself. The ocean again becomes my partner in this activity. I work with sand. My recent work a few days ago was inspired by a crab called sand blubber crab. Now this crab chews sand and spits out tiny balls of sand. And if you go to the beach during low tide, you will see wonderful patterns created by this crab on the beach. And I decided that I will do something inspired by this sand blubber crab. So I made my own balls and made a circle, which is called the sand blubber. When the crab creates this pattern, I do not know whether that can be called art, because creation of art requires an intention. Did the crabs have intentions? I do not know. But I definitely had an intention to create art when I created my balls of sand. I work with fishermen. It's a kind of a performance I create. Being a doctor, my patients, when I was practicing as a doctor, were all fishermen. And I could see their life from a very close angle. And I realized that life is inseparable from the ocean. And this inseparability of the life of the fisherman and the ocean is what I present through my performances, which I choreograph with fishermen. Behind the museum, I have a large space where I do my sculptures, especially large sculptures with all kind of materials. I have 6 people working with me all the time for the last 20 years. And we work with fiberglass, we work with clay, we work in ceramics, we work with rubber, we work with tires, old recycled tires, bottles, we work with with metal. And at any time, I am actually doing more than one work. You know, I have an advantage since I didn't go to the art college where there is all compartmentalized. There is a sculpture department, there is a painting department, there is a graphic department, there is perhaps textile department. Well, I had an advantage. I never went to art college, so I am not compartmentalized. I am a whole artist and I have total freedom. And so I don't know whether I should call myself a sculptor, I should call myself a painter. I am all in one. And I think I very much like a very new definition of art which I learned in Central St. Martin's in London, which talks about 2D art, 3D art, 4D art and 5D art. So I think I follow that kind of a pattern rather than compartmentalized pattern which is followed in most art schools in India. During COVID, I started thinking a lot about art education in this country and what I can contribute to it. I realized that in a country of 1.3 billion people, not more than 1 lakh people connect with contemporary arts. And it is very important to break this cultural barrier and take contemporary art to everybody. So we have decided to create talks on art. I have a YouTube channel and an Instagram channel, which is Subodh Kerkar. And we create small talks on art, on different aspects of contemporary art, which are available for everybody. What is important is we want to do this in different local languages of India, because English is spoken only by 10% of Indians, and actually English talks will be heard by less than 5%. So if you want to really educate this country about contemporary art, it has to be in local languages. So art education forms a very important part of my activity. I was a doctor once and I gave up my medical profession to pursue art 30 years ago. For last 30 years, I am only doing contemporary art. And I am very, very proud to tell you that, well, I have been a very, very happy person. It was a great decision which I took, because I believe that the only purpose of life is to be happy. And if you do something which you love to do, there is a possibility that you could be happy. And if you do something which you don't like to do, you'll be definitely unhappy. So folks, the message I have is, please pursue a passion, please do what you love to do.